Hi, I'm David Compton. Jessica Rose and Craig Maltman are out for the holidays. Well, 2019 is almost in the record books, and we've gone through all the news that we brought you this past year on the Trucker News Channel. And besides the serious news that affects truckers and their business, we've covered quite a few odd, funny, and strange stories this past year. So here's a compilation of some of the best of them. Enjoy. Sometimes we do stories here where it's best for me to just be quiet and let you watch. But here's a little setup. A Twitter user recently captured a video of a man hanging onto the back of a semi as it traveled at speeds of 50 miles an hour down the Dan Ryan Expressway. This guy's quite a dancer. If you watched our show long enough, you know we do a lot of animal cargo stories. Well, troopers recently found themselves hamming it up on a highway in Illinois. That's because a livestock hauler ran off the road and overturned on Interstate 70 near Casey, setting about 3,000 piglets on the loose. Unfortunately, about 100 of the piglets died in the actual crash itself. The surviving pigs were recaptured and continued on their way to a destination in Indiana. Representatives from several state and local police and fire departments helped corral the piglets. State police say the crash occurred due to driver illness. The driver was cited for improper lane usage. Here's a news headline for you. Man's crappy driving leads to bridge collapse. And the actual story is the headline is accurate in two different ways. That's because out in Snohomish County, Washington, the fire department received calls and were dispatched to the Old Owen Road at around noon, after receiving reports of a bridge collapse. When the officials arrived, they discovered the truck lying on its side in the creek. And what makes this story crappy is two things. Obviously, this guy's bad driving, but also the fact that he was carrying septic tanks. Fortunately, they were able to keep the fuel and anything else from emptying into the creek. The bridge is privately owned, and since it's located on private property, it's unclear if the weight tolerance of the bridge was posted. According to the sheriff's office spokesperson, the truck driver was able to crawl out of the truck before the cab plunged into the water. He was uninjured in the accident and probably just had the septic scared out of him.
We've all heard the saying, one man's trash is another man's treasure. Well, one Los Angeles truck driver has found a little bit of both, turning the dirt on his truck into art. 48-year-old Arturo Gonzalez graduated with an art degree, but started driving trucks in the year 2000 to pay the bills. Common to all truck drivers, one day Gonzalez was waiting at a warehouse to pick up a load. With nothing to do but wait, he drew his first piece of mobile art on his own truck. When that piece got him praise and attention, Gonzalez discovered his new canvas and now creates his art on a regular basis. We don't know if his art will make it into a museum yet, but it will make it onto the 405 freeway. So if you're in Los Angeles, keep an eye out for an Arturo original.
If you watched our show for any length of time, you know we love stories about chickens for some reason, so add this one to the list. It seems there was a barbecue on I-285 in Cobb County the other day, shutting down multiple southbound lanes of the interstate and causing hours of delays. 40,000 pounds of frozen chicken were roasted to a crisp when a tractor trailer caught fire. The truck's driver pulled over to the side of the interstate when he saw smoke and opened the back of the truck. He tried to put out the blaze, which he assumed was sparked by a malfunctioning brakes. Traffic was reduced to one lane for several hours while crews worked to put out the fire and clear the charred wreckage from the interstate.
Here's something for the guy that has everything. And if you're looking for value, this thing is worth millions. It's being sold right now for pennies on the dollar. It's your very own mega robot. That's right. The famous Eagle Prime is up for sale on eBay. The 30,000-pound two-seater made by Hayward, California-based Megabots with a chainsaw hand could be yours. This 16-foot-tall hydraulically operated tank with a LS3 V8 Corvette engine and about $2.5 million worth of parts is being auctioned off on eBay. Now, moving this robot isn't easy. Domestic costs for a round trip can be anywhere from $4,000 to $35,000 and will require a low-boy trailer and chains, but ramps are included with the winning bid. The owner says this, If you have your own truck to haul it, you can make a living hauling it around and doing private events. Just make sure you budget around $2,500 in fuel, repairs, and maintenance for each appearance. Now, things on this robot break, and you're going to have to change the oil every now and then.
Hey, this is Jesse James Dupree from Jackal, the Full Throttle Saloon, Jesse James Bourbon. Keep right in here for everything that is about the truck drivers saluting you, our great American cowboys. Truck Ball Show kicks.
Something's buzzing in Bozeman. That's because a tractor trailer with 40,000 pounds of bees flipped at the intersection in Bozeman, Montana. Apparently, a team of two truckers were en route from California to North Dakota with $100,000 worth of bees when they tipped trying to make a right-hand turn. The fire department arrived in full structure fire gear, including breathing apparatus, to try and minimize their risk of getting stung. Even the tow guys suited up in beekeeping outfits, which resulted in very few stings for everyone involved. A local bee expert said weather also helped the situation because it was cool and almost dark, and that the bees were likely to be much more docile than they would have been in other conditions. He further cited 40,000 pounds of bees would have been about 133 million insects. Luckily, only about 1,000 of them escaped from two of the 412 hives that were on board.
Fight or flight? Why not both? Figured a Fresno man caught on video making a dangerously daring escape from an altercation in the street. John Solis captured two men arguing at a gas station, one of which, Solis says, threw a garbage can at the other before the video began. The two men argued in traffic for 2 or 3 minutes before one of them suddenly hops onto the sidestep of a moving semi-truck and just rides off. It wasn't clear if the man just got off the truck or he was injured, but he was last spotted ride-sharing toward Highway 99. A clever getaway, but let's hope it doesn't become a trend in transportation.
When it comes to taking advantage of a spilled load, other than maybe a beer truck, there's only one other truck most of us would like to see lose its contents, and that's an armored truck full of cash. Well, that's exactly what happened when Atlanta area drivers were treated to a surprise when an armored truck spilled a load of cash onto the interstate. The incident happened around 8 p.m. on the westbound lanes of I-285 in DeKalb County, Georgia. Police say the side door of an armored truck came open, sending money onto the roadway. Around 15 drivers pulled off the interstate to try to collect the spilled cash, and it's not clear exactly how much money was lost during the incident, but it's estimated that it was around $100,000. Officials remind the public that it's not okay to keep the cash, and one person actually returned about $2,100 to the police. It's time for this week's viral video. We've done plenty of stories about bumper riders here in the past on the show, and the practice is never safe, and this video proves just how dangerous it can be. While it looks like the video was shot in another country, stupid is the same word in any language. Enjoy. No accident is a laughing matter. However, since the driver was okay in this mishap, we have to poke fun at it. As the old saying goes, there's no need to cry over spilt milk. And that's exactly what happened the other day as a tanker full of milk crashed near Grand Prairie, Texas. The tanker was on Interstate 30 in the wee hours of the morning when the driver fell asleep and drifted off the road. As you can see in the video, the tank ruptured, sending spilled milk everywhere. There was a rumor circulating that a Keebler truck hauling cookies might have also been involved in the accident, but unfortunately, that rumor turned out to be false. Many of us grew up with the children's story, The Little Engine That Could, and we remember the I think I can mantra. Well, we have some video of the little semi that thought it could, almost. Enjoy. We'll be right back. Well, that's it for this year-end episode. You know, there's a lot of people behind the scenes here at the Trucker News Channel that you never get to see. So here are those special people. Happy New Year's, everyone.